Oh, I'm off screen. Look at that.
Hello. Oh, hi.
Whoa, can people hear us? Are we here? Are we looking? Are we working? This is John Patrick.
Hey guys, what's up?
I'm gonna
back at it.
Info on the screen over my face. He's an actor and a writer. You can see his social media things and up there.
Wait, put the picture back up. I want to see if I can recreate it.
Okay.
Okay, right?
Yeah.
So it's like tilt. Oh, wait, no. It's tilting that way. So
yeah. There you go.
A little bit more. It's like this. Yeah.
I know. You look like 5 years younger in that photo. I'm sorry.
Oh, well.
You've gotten really old really fast.
I did.
Yeah. It's okay. That's okay. Happens to none of us, but it's...
happens just to me.
Yeah, just you. This aging thing is something just that you're dealing with.
I took that photo last week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
Me too.
It's smoking, man. It's a hell of a killer.
Cocaine is a hell of a drug. Yeah, it'll take you places, but it'll take you places. Know what I'm saying. All right. Hello, everybody. Can you hear us? I'm not looking at the chat, so I can't know. Look at my pink water bottle. Raag was able to supply me with this amazing pink water bottle. Pink. It's for everyone. It also looks good. This is actually one of my colors. Pink and blue are good colors for me. Blue because of my eyes and pink because of my skin tone.
Which is pink. Yeah, your skin tone's naturally pink.
It's pink.
Yeah. It's just too early for me to go this far into you, like, you know,
okay.
Just like,
I mean,
to roast
it's
you.
Not
I need
to really
a,
go too
I need
far
a space,
it.
I need to space
you can go into
it,
if
it
you
out.
Want.
I need to space it out properly.
Raag, you can always
over
go into
the
me.
Course of
a session.
This. Yeah.
Okay. No roasting yet. I mean, I only come in two shades, white and lobster. So there's that.
Yeah. I wore a shirt that tried to like. It's kind of like your face. It's like the pink. It's there. It's got a
it's
thing.
Pretty close.
It's close.
It's pretty close. You're not wrong, is the thing. He's not wrong. He's
wrong. I wanted
wrong.
To match him. I wanted to match. Okay, so here's the deal. We are here. We're going to be playing Quantum Break. This is John Patrick.
Hello.
And I'm Raag.
I'm currently signing into my Twitch because I got a new phone and trying to get back in.
See, there's this deity of me. You know,
it's so pretty. Can you just be that instead of your real face?
Yeah, I'll just cut out a mask one day of that
image.
And
just wear it?
And just wear it?
Just wear like the Minecraft box at all times, just over your face. That'd be great.
I think...
Right.
I think that's what we'll do.
Great. So... we've decided.
So thank you everyone for being here, and for all of those that are trickling in. We are playing Quantum Break today. Thank you everyone yesterday. If you haven't checked it out on Video On Demand, I highly recommend. I started playing Red Dead Redemption 2, with JJ and Jess were on the show yesterday, who are also, frequent guests to my stream. But I will continue to be playing that throughout the week at different times, as well as in more Saturday shows with guests. That game, we just gotta get done. We gotta get through it. It's a long game. We gotta get to the other side. Patrick will come and play it sometime.
I will. It's Saturdays, right?
Yeah,
most Saturdays I wake up around like 11:45. Sit in my bed watching some YouTube. I've gotten more into like a nerd writer, some script writing things, and I'm just kind of hang out for a few hours.
Now I'm just gonna ask, what's your Tuesday like? Is it pretty much the same thing?
No, my Tuesday is actually a lot more refined. Usually my weekends are actually Monday, Tuesday, because my weekends are Monday, Tuesday, because Saturday, Sunday is a lot of times busier for me than the weekdays. So a lot of times Tuesday, I will get up, go for a run, go to brunch. I have a brunch spot where I get avocado toast with some turkey. They have it all down there. And then I just kind of go through the day, going through all my emails. And at some point, I gaze into the abyss and then just wait for the abyss to gaze back. And when that happens, then I go to sleep.
Yeah.
That's my Tuesday.
Cool. Welcome to twitch.tv/Raagbot, which is now being named the TMI channel. we're gonna play this game. Thank you to Raag. My name is Raag, and mostly hair. And so Fabu is in my hair. I has dog, him very fluffy, his name Pico, driving is hard. This is accurate.
Driving is hard.
Sweet, okay. I'm reading your fun fact, and I'm very dubious about what you're doing at the moment with me and John Patrick.
Do I support it? I don't know. I'm curious. I don't know if I want to see it.
Speaking to Sweet Sandy Arts, if you grab that that little thing on there, thank her for sending these over to us. Starting the moment I get a silver Sharpie, I will start signing these and sending them out. She made these and sent them to me all the way from Germany, and I highly appreciate it. And it's cool. We're going to have little signed giveaways for a few of these streams coming up. So I will...
This is nice.
Yeah.
Story analysis is sexy.
Yeah.
It makes you look like the leader of a cult.
I mean, I am. I mean, they just don't know it yet, but
that's,
I am.
That's fair.
Yeah.
But do they?
Oh, it's been ingrained. Like, there's a trigger word and everything.
Okay.
It's great.
Would you kindly write about the TMI channel? Oh, they're looking up hair porn. That could still get bad. That could still get... very weird. People are into certain things, and hair is one of them.
I was thinking of the kind of porn that your hair watches. Like, because sometimes my hair, like, decides to be its own identity.
Okay.
And it kind of separates from my head, and it just, like, does things. Like, it started to twitch by itself.
Okay.
And I'm, like, pretty concerned it's going to, like, surpass, like, you know, like, Ninja pretty soon, because it's just out there doing things in the world. It's kind of like, it's like those AI movies. Anyways, we'll talk about her another day.
Does it play a lot of Harry Potter?
Hate you so much.
I was sitting on that one for the last 30 seconds. I imagine hair...
sending asterisms.
I imagine hair porn to just be like wind blowing in someone's face and just the hair fluttering out behind them like a flag.
Yeah.
Just shiny.
Yeah.
That's what hair porn is to me.
Anyways, coming future stream, we might, if my hair continues to be sentient, we might have to, like, eliminate it, and well, that would be a big game.
What?
You're looking like you wanna get into this thing.
No, the screen just went black. Is there anything else we need to talk about?
No, I think...
Is there?
No.
Is there
anything? I think we should, you know, queue up and we should play
so
a game.
We're going into it? All right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm gonna see, let's go to the gameplay and then see where our faces are. I adjusted yours. Scoot over a little bit? You wanna scoot that way? Oh, look at that. Look at that work. Oh, but your face is so much more prominent than mine. Let me fix that. That's
No, I'm good.
No,
it's
no.
Fine.
It's
great.
I don't think that's okay
it's,
for anyone.
You know what, Raag? It's exactly as it should be. Because my face is very big. Have you seen my forehead?
No, I mean, but it's not even proportions. Like,
you're right.
Yeah, that's rough.
Yeah, I look bad.
Yeah, it's not good. Thank you for the subscription. You want to... Okay, so this is going to be your box. I think that's a little closer to me.
I mean, my box. Yeah, cool sub. Cool sub.
Yeah.
You get to watch... you're just dabbing in the sub?
Yeah.
The sub? Oh, God. It's a great look. It's a great look.
Look at me dab. I'm clearly comfortable doing so.
All right, so... Ooh, I want to actually look at the timeline, just so I know. I have not played this game since the end of part 2. And so I don't know everything that's going on right now. So I'm just trying to catch back up. Back 2.
You're just trying to remember what happened. Don't worry about it.
Doesn't matter. We're not doing story analysis today.
Well,
we're
doing story analysis. We're doing the story analysis of the game as it goes through. I'm gonna turn off this video for you so you can survive your battery power.
Thank you. The one thing I do want to know is, has any other explanation been given for why this dude can murder everybody?
Yes. It turns out that he's been through some. Tight spots.
Tight spots,
That's all I got. So the main character in our game... By the way, this game is fantastic.
It's very good.
Especially
it's
cool because
good.
Amelia Rose Blair, a friend of The stream, a friend of mine, is in this game, and it's always cool to see her, and I think we might still see her in some parts of this game to come. But that being said, we do find the backstory of why our main character is such a good killer, even with time travel powers, slightly dubious.
Upon being asked why he, how he learned, where he learned all to kill and, like, use guns, the only line that was given as an explanation was, I've been in a few tight spots.
Yeah.
We don't know what tight spots those are. They could be in an alley somewhere. They could be, like, a really cool club that was tight.
I just, like, picture him. He got stuck in a tight spot, and then all of a sudden he could, like, be really good at killing people. I don't know.
Wait,
I don't
I've know. Gotten stuck behind my couch before. So
hold
that...
on a second. It looks like there's an issue with the screen.
Okay, I have to remember. Alright, so interesting. I think the last time I played, the last thing I did was also turn on the time machine, but it must not have worked. Alright, are there any powers that are new? Doesn't matter. Alright, come on, Jack.
We may have done, like, the last part of this already when we were last doing it, but we were just gonna start it again because of the checkpoint. We didn't reach it. I remember we got up to the point where we want to... Actually, I'm gonna take it from you just for this part because we, like... This took us, like, maybe 20, 30 minutes to do. And I wanted to get it right. People keep calling me. What's going on?
He's nope. popular. You're popular.
I'm not, though.
Wait, we were just up there.
I know. I'm just tracing my steps.
I gotta crawl around the wall.
I'm trying to remember all the controls and all the such things.
It's Y for Eagle Vision. Oh, there you go. Oh! Death.
I actually am not sure where that needs to go. We might have already done this part.
Let's activate the
cord. You might just follow wherever that yellow thing was, because we might have already come up here and flipped whatever switch you're supposed to do here. I'm not, like, sure where it's, like, left us off exactly. Because I think we had to flip that switch, but we already did so.
Okay, so that's at the end of here. So it looks like... There we go. Da-da-da. All right, here we go. Typing in the computer. It's turning like on the machine.
Yeah, okay. That's, yeah, we got to right over.
Who is this doc?
It's ready.
Sophia Amaro. We got her.
Actually functional.
Okay, I was just looking up a call.
Okay, we're doing this.
Oh, thank you, Apu.
I'll set the date into the console.
He'll do what? There we go.
July 4th.
Thank you all for being here.
Yeah, hi everyone. How many people are watching? We had 29 viewers.
No.
I've got 33 here.
Are you?
I'm gonna go with my number.
I'm gonna go with yours.
No.
This is it. There's no turning back.
Hey, wait, wait. What did you do? That was the wrong door.
There's Amelia Rose Blair.
Where is she? Where is she?
I had no choice. I couldn't let you take the countermeasure. It would put our entire plan at risk. I already called Monarch from the terminal. They're on their way. It's over.
Fuck!
We need the countermeasure to run the lifeboat.
follow through with the plan. Tie her up and get as far away from here as you can.
I will. You just take care of yourself, Jack. Okay?
No. Alright.
So, yeah, I believe where we kind of left off is that he was trying to get the machine started up again so he can travel to a time to put an end to kind of the shenanigans that's been going on.
So there's been a lot of talk of like the end of time or how time is broken. How did time break exactly? Is that me or is that someone else? Yeah, it is. Look at his face. Oh, so red, so angry. What? When the Molly hits.
Your first journey back in time, 2010. This is where our notes get hazy.
You know how it ended.
Your goal when you arrived was to retrieve the countermeasure.
But my goal had to wait. Because I wasn't alone.
Are you not getting audio?
No, I was just turning the audio up.
This game is really a good use of, like, budgetary. Like, I really feel like, I mean, obviously this game cost a lot.
What's going on here?
There's, you know, TV episodes, which we're not watching on stream, but they're really cool.
None of this crap was here in 2016.
Meh. I don't have to read it.
What's this?
Hey, Bobby Radford coming at you.
Yeah, so the way this game is structured, which we have been, I've been kind of telling people to watch the shows at home, which I don't think many people are. But essentially what it is that the main cast is filled with actors from well-known sci-fi TV shows, and then including Emilia Rose Blair, who was in one of the TV episodes. And then they did four episodes, like 22-minute dramatic episodes of a TV show, essentially. And those are spreading through the story. And I think there's one left that we're going to skip because we want to keep going.
Beth?
It's me. Hey. What happened to you?
So Beth has long hair now and is not a cop. Person.
This is it. There's no turning back.
I mean, she had like a vlog, yes, yeah. But.
Jack?
So we're kind of seeing what happened to her. Game looks beautiful. I mean, this game's like 2 years old and it's beautiful.
It still looks great.
Dr. Emerald sent me to the future. I fought for months trying to find a way to get back. I wasn't the only one.
Oh, geez,
that's Paul.
It's Paul on his first, the very first time we see him.
Yeah.
Stop!
This was where he first won.
He set William's machine to 1999, the first possible exit point.
Right, because that's when he first built the machine.
It's okay. Hey, it's okay. I'm on your side.
Who are you?
I'm Beth Wild.
It's Dominic Monaghan. So she managed to go back and warn our main character, Sean Ashmore's brother, Jack's brother.
And you've been here ever since. 11 years. Why? Why didn't you come back?
We should get ready.
So she's been hiding.
We don't have much time.
Waiting for him to come.
Hmm. And so Paul went in 2014?
Yeah. My wife's good, but, you know,
she
regrets that statement. A bunch of people on Twitch thought JJ
eyes.
Was my wife.
She was hiding something.
She always was.
What is?
What exactly do you believe changed in Beth?
She lost hope.
Alright. Just some background, what happened to her, the sadness, the decay. No, she's that way, but what's up here?
Hey, Lysa.
Nope. You know, something to be said for a good narrative game. Too many games now are open 11 world.
Years.
Yeah, and the open world thing is an interesting thing, because I do think it does make it a little harder to do straight narratives.
Yeah.
But I mean, so it's all on how it's done, man.
Where's the countermeasure?
The countermeasure's at William's workshop, where he built it.
Okay, so we're trying to get to the countermeasure.
Mm-hmm.
Then that's where we go.
Yes. That was the plan. I just have to unlock this.
Get your gun out.
My supplies are upstairs. We'll need to get them. There's so much you don't know that you never saw. I gave up on the idea that she would ever come.
I need to know we're still in this together.
I told you once our fate is already laid out for us. I still believe that. More than ever. I'm just worried what that might mean.
Well, that's not cryptic.
It means
cryptic.
We finish this.
Kind of boring.
You need gear? Take whatever you need. The rest of it's going in the river. Along with everything else I brought here.
Ooh, fancy assault rifle?
That's a little
drastic. Well, what do we have right now?
My time here is done, Jack.
Assault rifle, advanced assault. Oh,
I have to erase my presence.
Whatever that gun on the left is needs to get ammo.
Let me know when you're ready to go.
Oh, I know, shotgun. Semi-auto shotgun, faux show.
We loading up guns! Because we're going to not hurt anyone.
Wet machine, semi-auto... Carbine rifle? Semi-auto shot? Okay, carbine rifle? No. What about...
Alright, what's going on in the chat? What's happening? What are
yeah,
we talking
what's
about?
What's happening, chat people? Light auto machine gun? Tactical SMG? Semi-auto shotgun? Oh, wait, no.
Ready when you are, Jack.
Pistol for show. Semi-auto shotgun. Alright, cool. Wait, gonna stack up on all ammo. Let's do it. Alright, bae.
I can't imagine what happened to you.
She's been
you
hanging around for 11 years.
I didn't know where Sophia sent you or how to find you.
You made it here. It's all that matters. You followed the plan.
Whatever happened to you, change it.
Don't.
We can fix this.
Don't.
We can undo this.
Oh, you still don't get it. It can't be changed. No matter what we do, the pieces fall in all of the exact same places. I've tried. Over and over.
I can't just sit back and do nothing.
You have to let go. Jack.
I can't just do nothing.
You have to let go. I've seen it. The end of time.
That is where she sent me. I was there. I've been fighting this fight my entire life, and I saw us fail.
I'm watching everything that's going on in the chat, and I'm very alarmed by all of it.
Are they talking about bees? What is this about bees?
I just don't know anymore.
There's bees, there's poems.
I don't
poems.
Know if we can win this thing.
Oh, send us poems. Haikus.
Yes.
It's haiku challenge right now.
Yeah. John Patrick and I want haikus.
Yeah.
We want all the haikus.
Are they in love? Or are they just about to shoot people?
They'll die finding out.
They're about to get into tight spots together.
Yeah, they are. Anyone up for a squeeze behind the couch? Will's workshop.
A wee bit squeeze behind the couch. I only write plotless fluff and gay angst.
You know, plotless fluff and gay angst can be turned into a haiku. Plotless fluff
is gay. angst. No, it's 575.
Plotless
right?
fluff is gay. Gay angst is full of.
I don't want to make gay sound like a pejorative. It's not a pejorative. It's very positive.
It could either be homosexual or it could be happy. The actual.
Neither of which is a pejorative.
Neither of which is a pejorative.
I don't know a fraction of the hell that Beth went through.
Gay angst, plotless fluff. That's fine.
She saw the end
right.
of time, how that changed her, like it changed Paul.
There
followed
you
by 11 years
how
of living
you
like
write.
A ghost.
I'm not seeing any haikus, guys.
Beth I'd known had laser focus. This Beth.
I call everything gay. It's fine. Great. Good.
She had doubts. You okay?
Yeah.
But the countermeasure. The one thing that could set things right was waiting for us at Will's workshop.
There it is.
In 2010, Monarch didn't own the area yet. That came shortly after because of what happened with you. But we knew William was building something new in his workshop, and we knew it must be important. We were monitoring the place.
Yeah, Beth knew about your presence. She'd done spying on her own. We came over the rooftops to avoid detection.
Does Will know we're coming?
No, he doesn't.
Okay, so the interview in the future is with a Monarch lady. Interesting. I don't know if you guys knew that.
I did not.
From this point on, we may be in their sights. We need to be quick.
Yeah, I've had worse. Tipping.
Hey, Will?
He's not here. I made sure of that.
What? Why? He's the only one that knows how to use the countermeasure.
Which is why he needs to be kept safe. In case... things go bad.
Fine. We get the device, then you leave me my brother.
Sure.
Now, where do we find this thing?
Will said he secured it inside a safe. Somewhere in the building.
All right, Will. Where'd you hide that safe? This must be where he built it.
Guess who?
Yeah.
Where'd you hide the safe?
Hey, River Boy. I'm pretty sure you folks are having a
There once was a Raag who did streams. His viewers made a lot of memes. His friends came along and played games all day long as the chat went and lived their gay dreams.
Limericks. Yes, that is what we're talking about. Who put that down? Bumblebees. Yes.
You'd been there before. Witnessed flashes through time. I assume pieces
Raag
of
is fabulous. His hair, our lord and savior, all hail Bumble.
And some are yet to come.
Oh, congratulations to your sister-in-law who's going to have a baby soon.
The device wasn't there, but it must have been at one time. The power setup wasn't working, but it must have worked at some point. Maybe I can rewind time to get this working.
It was all there on the board. The details of his downward spiral. His work consumed him. Became some kind of desperate obsession. He was never the same.
Alright, so we're looking for a safe.
Door's locked. Knowing Will, that's where the safe is. Just need to find a way in.
Shit.
Locked out again.
Where was the failsafe switch?
Follow the wire.
Which one was it?
Blue?
Or was that the emergency shutdown?
Oh, shit.
Okay.
I knew I should have labeled the wiring.
What's up, Cosmicky? I know we can always count on you for the doctor who references. I like these, though. Haikus are hard. Yo. We can't just do whatever.
Shit.
But we love you, Raag. Thank you.
Damn it. Yellow wire, I knew it.
Alright, what are we trying to do?
Alright, we're trying to find this yellow wire, where this yellow wire goes. And the yellow wire needs to plug into something.
I built a goddamn time machine, but I can't remember to keep a piece of shit door unlocked.
God fucking damn it. Okay. Okay, here we go. Oh, interesting. So you're able to...
Shit.
Nope.
Where was the failsafe switch?
Guys, I'm good at the shooting and killing people part, but I'm apparently failing at pretty much all the other things.
Yeah, I don't really view you as a puzzle doer. I kind of view you as kind of like the equivalent of a video game, like... You're the brawn.
Okay.
I'm the brains of the operation.
That's,
and
this
the looks.
Is fair. This is, and the looks. He's the hair.
Yeah. Yeah, all of these things.
What?
Emergency shutdown initiation.
Shit.
Okay, so... Turn back time, which is really cool. There it is. Okay, so I only have a few seconds. Okay. I got it now.
Damn time machine.
Go.
I keep trying to type in twitch.tv/Raagbot on Twitter, because I'm writing a tweet, and it just keeps doing twitch.tv/Raagnot, and I'm not really appreciating it.
You're not.
I'm not.
You're not.
Not.
Not you. Time machine designs. Who thought that time travel would be a good idea?
You didn't leave the code. But I can crack it. Just need some time to...
Not Raag.
Somebody's here.
It's Monarch.
I think to Blue Owls and Amy A, who are both awesome people. I spent a lot of time with them at TwitchCon, and they have been helping me mod.
Stay inside.
They're super cool.
Yeah.
We all hung out in my hotel room and modded Bryan's stream when he was live while we were there. It was fun.
All right. Now it's...
You'd been spotted the moment you arrived. You never had a chance. You were on a suicide mission.
What?
Yeah. I wasn't going to lie down and just give up without a fight. Not then, not ever.
This is Trojan 1 approaching workshop perimeter. Over.
Remember, orders are to take her alive. Monarch Actual is en route.
Roger.
So we're about to get a huge fight.
Stop right there. Where's the girl?
Hey.
It's a tight spot.
Take it easy.
He's got a gun. Open fire. What the fuck was that?
There's no melee. You're doing really well right now.
Yeah, there we go. Okay, I gotta switch to a better gun.
Flank him.
Just gonna chill right here, and everybody's just gonna come around this corner for the grand. Come here.
Woo! This is violent.
That is how you take care of it.
Whoa, face!
We got a situation. Let's sit, rep.
Yeah,
he's got backup.
Switching.
I don't know what he is. Orders are to keep the mission quiet, tidy. We can't afford right. unwanted attention.
Push it up. Use your time travel powers.
Oh Jesus, I am.
Yeah, you're not doing very well. There you go. Get that guy. There's definitely a sniper we gotta handle. Yeah, I think it's just automatically does it when you approach him. Okay, you gotta get the snipers in there. Using your shotgun's not gonna help.
So this is you!
Just telling you how a shotgun works. It's pellets! Moves! It spreads!
Whatever. Oh, fuck. Oh, man. Okay, I'm here. Oh, Jesus. Healing. And go time. Oh, come on, man. Reload faster than that. Okay. I need a sniper.
Got.
Oh, one.
That guy's right behind you.
Dead.
No.
More
memes. More chat commands. Yeah, I should update my chat commands.
Wow.
Discord chat commands. How about that? Silver Sharpies.
There we go.
Look at you.
Alright, I need some ammo.
Get out of my way.
Here we are again. Exactly where we left off years ago.
God damn it.
Paul.
Bryan's doing a lot of cool content right now. I think, obviously, once he gets back from China, I know he's going to be streaming Spyro, the new Spyro game. He's going to do some Red Dead, and he's going to do another playthrough of Detroit Become Human, so or at least another chunks of it. So those are all things you guys should check out and look out to mid-November-ish when he gets back.
Okay, so that's a smash.
Just so you know, if I write you guys the commands you're looking for, they're going to be very sarcastic and not what you actually want. I'm going to specifically, like, my chatbot is kind of like one of those evil genies that takes everything that you ask it and turns it against you, and that's pretty much what I'm going to do. So what you should really be asking for is, could I get a non-PSB command? Because then maybe I will.
Maybe not. Who knows? Oh, wait, we've seen...
They're all in
this.
China right now. The Dechart's. The great people.
Come with me. We can survive this together. You
hey,
know
Flounder.
It can't be
stopped. Flounder. Flounder?
I can see it in
Flounder.
Your eyes.
Flounder. Flounder.
You know this.
Complete Act 4.
What if you're wrong?
So we're going to come up to a TV episode we're going to skip. And then we're going to go into the
Get
last
it.
Act of the game.
Get it. What?
So that's the failsafe, right?
Apparently, yeah. It's a countermeasure.
The countermeasure, right.
That has just been switched on? Put my hands up, I'm playing the song.
We failed. We created Ground Zero.
Oh, we haven't been back in this screen for a while.
Everything to happen how it
always
did.
Because he was telling his story.
Every piece
falling into place?
Except one. The blast sent you through time, brought you back to 2016. The same exact time from which you left. Something anchored you there.
Oh.
We need to know how you did this.
You think I wanted to come back? I was pulled away. Everything I came for was still back there. Left behind.
I don't know what happened in the chat, but you guys have fun with that.
Garrus, yes! What is happening? Alright, guys. For those of you in America, remember to vote. That's all I'm gonna say. That's all I have to say to chat.
Yeah.
Right now.
Oh.
No, Beth.
Unless you disagree with me politically, then don't vote.
Beth, come on, move.
Beth, you know what? That's a good point.
Beth, come on, get up. Please, Beth. Beth, you need to move. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Get the gun. Come on, Beth, move. Come on, please. Beth, move! Paul, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't!
I'm not wrong.
You can't.
No! No!
Oh, so he's just seeing a reflection of what happened that it was years ago. Because
yeah.
He got
Doreen
sent through.
Had the countermeasure the whole time. I had to get it back.
A rash decision. You claim Beth Wilder's death had no impact on your behavior, but...
Like I said, I barely knew her.
So, asterisms, then, in theory, you should be voting where you used to, but what I would recommend is you should be able to get a provisional ballot, no matter what, in the United States, and they'll have to accept your vote, at least you put it in, and it's counted if it, you know, in ties and stuff, so I think it's important.
What?
Someone was asking a question about voting. If the state of Illinois did not recognize that he's lived there for a year, if it's too late for you to register in your original state of living, you could potentially try a provincial ballot. Provisional ballot. I don't know.
Yeah, that sounds about right. You know more about politics than I do. So.
I've done it. Dabbled.
Yeah!
I was a political science double major in college, along with film production.
So, apparently, I found out, I got a new phone. I got a Galaxy S9, got off the Apple train, and they have a thing where if you turn your volume on a headset up past a certain point, they're like, you don't do this because it's dangerous. It's a lot quieter than you think it would be.
I spent 17 years working it out, planning it, building Monarch, because I knew what was coming and I knew it couldn't be stopped. But what I've built has been turned against me. What is the point in saving them if I can't trust them?
Chat. Sweet.
You too.
I'm slipping away. To pain and rage.
Who wants us to make out? Vote on chat.
The sickness is accelerating.
I'm not joking.
Yeah.
CFR.
I'll work on my technique.
So much. But I have harnessed
it. And they all said no.
No? Yeah.
With it, my plan will work. With it, I will keep the lights on when the world goes dark.
Mr. Serene?
Do you have good feelings or bad feelings about it, as Serene?
Meet me in my office, soldier. I'll be there when I've sealed the CFR chamber.
Because his accent has always been weird for me, no matter what... how he's speaking, because his voice always just pokes through a little bit.
Okay, so we're at that junction point. We're going to get to the episode where they're probably going to spend a lot of time talking about this character, and we're going to skip it because we're going to get into the game and the action of it. If you are interested in seeing TV episodes, you can actually YouTube them all, and they're all very easy to find.
CFR has been secured.
Mr. Serene, I'm in your office.
I'll be right there. Serene out. This soldier doesn't know how close to the end I am. I'm not afraid of death. I'm afraid of becoming the enemy.
I do think the visuals in this game are amazing.
For me, for the plan.
It's also amazing how the effects, like that, like how the effects of time and the cracks manifest themselves.
Don't know who to trust anymore.
So what is his plan?
Sophia Amaral. She wanted to activate the lifeboat before it was ready. She wants to sabotage my operation. Who knows what she's told Jack? Who knows how long she's been working against me?
What exactly is his plan? I think it's to continue the experiments. I mean, he's trying to maintain the integrity of the...
Oh, I want to read about his life. Maintain the integrity of time.
Sure. Yeah.
Be right with you, son.
Some...
Report.
Sir, you ordered us to search the demolished lab. Your treatments were destroyed, but... There was one left. The casing appears to be broken, but it's all we could find.
One of my treatments. But it's damaged.
So this is what keeps him alive.
Is it safe to use?
Sir?
Yeah, you don't know what you've started here. I agree with that, Patrick.
What?
Or is it a trap?
Just be careful what you read.
Another betrayal.
There's a lot there.
Oh, you buy me a pineapple pizza?
The treatment will make me weak.
I don't know if that's...
Is that what they want?
Rag trick.
Can any of
there are services to send streamers food? You would have to know where I live first, so that's not good. That's not going to happen. I think.
Ugh. All right. That's... Yeah. Okay, so what we're choosing right now is... Show control. I don't know. He's wondering whether or not he should take the medication.
I'm not a traitor.
We're the same now. And I need your help.
Yeah, send it to my P.O. box.
Mission. Lifeboat. See it through to the end. I still have allies I can trust.
Look, you have to realize you're not going to keep me from getting the CFR.
Walk away, Joyce! Liam Burke. He would fight to defend us. To slow Jack down. The plan could still work.
Got it. Alright, let's see what surrender is.
You have all betrayed me.
Yeah, you don't need to send me pizza. It's okay.
I mean, you can send me a pizza.
No.
He'll take the pizza.
I will assure
Thanks for the chair, sweets.
My word. Be renewed. My world will see balance.
Chaos. It's falling apart. They're working against me. They're fighting each other.
We'll need to get to Serene's office. He's got direct access to the CFR. All right?
Joyce fixes the fracture. He fixes the world. And I'll go home happy.
Charlie Wincott. Another weakling, a traitor.
I would love
Jack.
To see what they would say if I sent a pizza to a P.O. box.
Suffer, all of them.
Treat stream.
All right, what are we doing? What is the chat thing we should do? Control or surrender? Because it's going to prompt a movie that we're not going to watch.
But it is actually going to affect how we play.
Correct.
Because I actually saw a playthrough of Act 2 when it first came out. Where we had Act 2, the end of Act 2 was in, like, a construction yard. or like a dockyard. And another style of Act 2 was on a bridge with a protest. So, pizza? Control? So I have one for control. And many for pizza.
You guys are participating like classly.
And a few for making out.
Okay, control seems more in character. What's up, Trek 21? Cool.
Control seems...
Now again, we're not going to watch the video that comes out of this because we want to keep going with the game. But I encourage you to search YouTube Act 4 Control and you'll be able to find it.
Mm. I agree, it does seem more character.
Hashtag always make out. Look what you started.
I'm not sad about it.
Yeah.
That's where the gay fluff comes in. Yes.
More clear-headed. Calmer. But it won't last. I need to work fast.
Y'all are wild.
While I still can. Bradbury swimming pool.
It's always the Bradbury swimming pool. 60% of the community agreed with the choice. Have you normally chosen the
One time we didn't.
What was that? Chose to murder everyone?
Yeah, once. It was needed. Alright, we're gonna go back into this game.
Is Amelia still... I'll come back for you. Is Amelia still alive? Or is she dead?
I think she was in the future, and now that we're back, we've been jumping around time, we kind of lost
that's
her.
That's right. Like vehicles and pedestrians. Or ships and bridges.
Would now be a good time to share a movie?
To share the thing?
Oh, let's get to this first.
Okay.
While authorities and relief workers from Monarch are redoubling their efforts, it seems everybody's working at capacity.
Time was broken. Working out of sync. The city was in a state of chaos.
What?
The end of time was closing in.
And you still believed you could fix it?
The solution was inside Monarch Tower. A countermeasure.
The CFR, as Monarch knew it. The key to the lifeboat protocol. Monarch's survival plan. But that didn't seem to matter to you.
I had a better plan.
Alright,
I had a better plan.
So,
what
we'll do is we'll show this movie that John Patrick over here starred in and wrote. Did you work on it?
No. Just start
in. Alright, cool. You start in it. There is a little, disclaimer. So, the movie... I'm gonna do it without spoiling it. It does decide to make fun of how would you like to? That's not the right
word. I don't want to say it makes fun of. It deals with some dark matter, specifically with suicide, and it is a comedy. It is a very dark comedy. It is in no way poking fun at said affliction. It actually deals a lot with kind of the stress and the decision making that goes into it, and is in the end a tale of redemption. But this is just the short version, which is kind of a more of a teaser for the feature that we want to make.
Right. So I think that what's key here is that because it's just a piece of it, it's not like the entirety of the story, and so it may, you know. So anyways, but it's cool. I had fun watching it, so I want to share it with you guys. So here is the fine line, which is a 4-minute short, 4.5-minute comedic short.
Yeah.
Starring John Patrick here. And we will show it. We did not show it properly. Hold on, let me get it queued up.
Okay, I'm gonna go throw out my food.
Thank you.
Who are you?
Shut up! Yeah, I'm ready. What are the instructions? What? Wait, who is this? Wrong number. Bitch. Fucking wrong number.
Are you here to kill me?
Yes. I'm here to kill you.
Yes! Oh my god, yes!
What?
This is perfect!
Shut the fuck up or I'll kill you!
I'm ready.
Perhaps you're not understanding.
No, I get it. Pull the trigger.
What are you, crazy?
What's the holdup? Just pull the trigger!
Shut up! I give the orders here. You are the hostage. I'm the guy with the gun.
Yeah, and I don't want to be on this earth anymore. So, ready when you are.
Okay, just so we're clear, I'm not an actor.
Yeah.
This isn't a joke.
Okay.
And this is a real gun. Here, look.
Great, it's real.
What the fuck's the matter with you, fucking weirdo? Were you expecting anyone?
No.
Are you sure?
Actually, I did order a package.
Seriously?
Uh-huh.
They can't hear us if we don't move.
Okay.
Let's just keep quiet, and then eventually we do.
Fine!
Just answer the door, make them go away.
Well, is anyone there? So, was anyone there?
Disgruntled mailman.
What?
This isn't even my handwriting.
What's in the box?
I think I know what it is.
What the fuck is this?
Is that it?
What, is there supposed to be more?
No, that can't be it. Where's the rest of it?
I'm so confused right now.
There's supposed to be a gun in there!
I'm still not getting it.
Before you came, knocked me out, and tied me to that chair,
uh-huh.
I was waiting for this to come so I could shoot myself.
Come again?
Literally before you came, I was trying to kill myself.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Why would I be kidding you?
First of all, that explains a lot. Second of all, you're gonna have to wait.
Wait? Wait for what?
I got orders, Dave.
Who cares about your orders? Just kill me already!
Don't you want to know who wants you dead?
No!
Alright, look, I don't make the rules. I just fucking kill people. So sit back and relax. Death is coming. Patience is a virtue.
Fuck patience!
Hey! Oh. Come on, Dave. I do this for a living. I'm a professional, Dave.
Hey.
No, wait!
What the fuck? What is this? Where am I?
I told you not to do that.
All right. Well. So this is the beginning of what's going to be a
feature film, a longer film.
So I assume you're in the rest of it. It's not.
Yes, I am. that is kind of that's kind of like the end of the first act, right there. Would be the idea. There's also a couple other characters that would be involved in a longer one, but that is the bare bones. And then what happens after that is the rest of the story. I don't want to give too much away, but there is a twist to it that is that it really does, like I said before, it turns into a story of redemption and healing It is above all else, it is a story about healing and coming out from that dark place.
Yeah, and I think what comedy, you know, suicide as a comedic element is actually a pretty common kind of macabre theme that's existed in through many dark comedy kind of elements. And I think that it can be used to educate us about the overall subject, especially, like, I think what he's saying, this story is more about redemption and actually might, you know, show more of an arc. And I think that that's, I think it's understandable. It's like, it's hard to laugh at this stuff and you shouldn't, like, take it lightly. But at the same time, it's also a way to kind of cope with the mechanism that is, you know, depression and things mm-hmm. like that. I think humor has long been a healing tool for those that are seeking kind of the right state of mind and solace mm-hmm. out of that.
And it's also, I find it an easier way to talk about things. Because yes. if you, especially for relating to people who don't have afflictions such as depression or suicidal tendencies, it is a way to kind of show people and open up a dialogue as to how that can affect their friends and family. And I think comedy is a very good community building and conversation starting tool.
I totally agree. And just talking about the film, you're funny.
I know. Yeah. Who would have thought?
Who would have thought? And the other actor who plays the other hitman is actually really funny too, so.
Yes, he is Rocco Bovo. He is actually an incredible actor. He is also a producer. He's working on a few things right now. But the two of us have worked on a few projects together, but this is probably the biggest thing that we've worked on lately. And we're really excited to make this into something that we can all be proud of and send to our mothers. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to send something to my parents, be like, this yeah. is what I do.
Yeah, no, totally. So this is great. I put information in the chat for some phone numbers you can talk to. If, you know, anytime you talk about suicidal ideation and things, I think it's just important to remember that, you know, it's a serious thing that, you know, and you always have resources out there and available to you. But I also think it was fun to check out a film that is trying to tell a story that, you know, muddles into an area that's difficult, but at the same time I think does what it's supposed to. Cool. Well, thanks for showing that.
You're welcome.
Is there like a website people can learn more about?
There is a website. Thefinelinemovie.com, I believe.
I'll look that up first so we don't
miss. Let's just check that. Finelinemovie.com. Go up to the... Yeah, thefinelinemovie.com to find out more about all of the making of any of the production, and there's a lot about kind of the tone that we're going for, the feel, why it's being made, why at this time, and then yeah, there's a bunch of things about my face on there. You want to see my face in a bunch of different
okay, I'm sorry I put that link in the chat, guys. I apologize.
Look at my face! Spend enough time looking at his. Look at mine now.
Yeah.
Okay, which one is tune? You. Okay, I'm going to do this.
That's a good point, ecstatic asterisms. I think it's important that we have a good sense and understanding of mental health issues in a thing. Why? Why, hello there, buddy.
Smells like sex in the
air. Ugh. Definitely doesn't.
Okay. Yeah. I smell
by,
sex.
By sex, I mean Taco Bell.
I did have some barbecue. Oh, we're trying to convince Rog to let me kiss him.
Okay, kiss him.
James, that was James, by the way. Are you running off?
No, I'm just opening the door. It smells like taco sex in here.
I've been really tried, baby.
Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. You can get the cheek. You can get the cheek. Okay.
What's
okay.
with the homophobia? Just give me a kiss. Huh?
Yeah! There we go.
That just happened.
Let's go into this game. Hold on. I'm going to widen up. James, do you want in frame with me?
I might.
Cool. Okay.
Alright.
We're at the end of the game, it's like the last half. So, I'm going to have a phone in can get grabbed from the living room.
Jesus Christ.
Alright, yeah, it's in the living room in the white thing next to the TV, and then I'll widen up the box.
Just as long as it's drinking the beans and doing it.
Fair.
Just give up.
I don't see anyone. Where are the people? Are there people shooting me? I can't see them. Oh, there they are. Jesus Christ. Where? There's way too much. Stop shooting at me! Lest I must kill you all! Alright, you.
Alright, yeah, let me kill things. I wanna kill things!
I'm sorry!
This is the biggest damn building I've ever before.
Is this where I'm going?
I don't know. Oh, wait. Keypad.
Jack?
I'm gonna kill things!
I hope you can hear me.
Fiona? Is that you?
Office. A friend of mine has unlocked the
Do you want me to also kiss James? Because I can.
I think I could help you with that. Like this.
I guess you can.
Jesus.
We're gonna finish this. I really don't remember the controls.
Nice. Murder for Raag.
Getting some murder in.
A burst fire pistol.
Do I not have that?
You have a heavy pistol.
I'll take the burst fire. In fact, I love using the automatic ammo weapon, because it's just like, I feel more badass with like the small thing.
I was getting closer to the countermeasure. Paul had the key to fixing the fracture all along, but he didn't see it.
There was nothing to see. He believed the fracture couldn't be fixed. That's why he used the countermeasure, the CFR, to create.
I think it's appropriate that you and James get to finish this game since you started this game.
That's also fair.
Yeah.
But James is currently not here. But...
yeah, you know.
It's appropriate that he's in the vicinity.
It's appropriate that we're talking about him, even though he's not really ever present.
Right. That's we can't let him know that we're also talking about him, otherwise that would just imply zero.
He doesn't watch the screen.
What the fuck is that? Damn.
What the? What's going on here?
You got a little charger thing? Your my charge thing?
Right here for the phone?
Oh, yes. May I use this?
Sure, John.
Yeah.
Those men died fighting something that lives outside of time.
Our hair's looking very similar, James.
Weapons program was built.
Mine's much crazier.
Weapons weren't doing the trick.
Wait, so these guys are dead? Why?
I'm assuming that, like, yeah. Paul is running around using his powers.
Company here.
Wow, this gun's not very good at, like...
Oof. And then nuts? Lean? Come on, use your timey-wimey powers. LB. LB to go forward, and then you press the left trigger. There you go.
What's the bomb one? RB, right?
RB, hold down. There you go. Oh!
Woo!
Dead.
Woohoo!
Deader than dead. Can't go around that one. It seems very hard to die in this game. Like in a gunfight, especially at this high level. Oh my god! And there he is with a rocket launcher. I guess that something about that ammo. I dodge around.
Is there a backpack of ammo? I need a backpack of ammo.
Don't you have unlimited with burst fire, though? You have SMG ammo. There you go. Just looting the dead bodies. Can I UPS myself over to LA? I mean...
No! You can't! It's very illegal! Love to see you guys, but very illegal. Alright, I got this guy done.
Okay, good. I just got another one.
I need to get him away from that wall because it makes it harder.
I don't think he's moving. He's back. Here, try. There's like a ground smash move where you.
Yeah, he just dodges that.
I think it's the armor. He's impervious. So.
What's the other move that I have?
If you hold LB, it's like a ground smash. It doesn't feel like anything.
No, it's very difficult to hit them.
There we go.
Woohoo!
Jeez.
Oh, there's so much. I don't... I do not,
endorse human trafficking?
No, it does not. No.
But, like... if it's voluntary... if you're volunteering to track yourself...
No!
To traffic yourself...
No! I'm only gonna respond to this with one thing. No!
I, for one, don't endorse it either, but it's fun just to think about, you know?
No! I care about you all!
Skybridge. Skybridge. I'm marketing right now. That's... okay. Yeah.
Who's Fiona again?
Hey, Jack. Be careful. There's something really weird going on in this building.
Monarch was scrambling.
I remember.
Okay.
Paul's empire was falling apart all around.
I'm like, well,
I'd never seen anything like it.
Except for the burst vial.
But Paul had. That's what he was preparing for all those years.
That's all I want. That's all I care about.
He didn't do a very good job.
All right, there we go. Got some ammo. I'll get a soda on the way. Wait, make sure you get a Pepsi. Go into the...
it's a sizzle, not a Pepsi.
Sorry, get a sizzle.
You've tried. Pepsi is already suing me for $8 million. Thank you for that.
Alright. Ooh, that dude is dead.
Holy shit.
I feel like at the end of this tunnel, I'm gonna fight a boss that's pretty good at this stuff, because he's clearly...
probably Paul. Have you ever played, Transistor?
No.
Great game. Fantastic game. Turn-based game. Bastion Powers. Same people who made Bastion.
Shit.
But at the end, you fight someone who has the same powers as you. And it's really intense.
Paul's machine. Looks like they have it on the top floor.
Sounds cool.
Anybody in chat play Transistor? Okay, we're not equating being gay with human trafficking. First of all. Jesus Christ.
You've been quite the chat today.
Hey, you know what? You offered to kiss one man and suddenly everybody's going wild.
Been unleashed!
So it seems that even though Paul tried to control himself, he couldn't.
He's a monster! You played yourself.
What the fuck? Was that Hatch?
Hatch? Is Hatch also timey-wimey?
All personnel, stay clear of the lower levels.
Did you just say timey-wimey?
Why not?
Timey-wimey. Stay clear of the lower levels.
We're getting back into Doctor Who. With Fiona.
You're at Serene's office. Good. Just a second. This one's a little tricky. Serene's got access to the CFR chamber, and there's something pretty dangerous. Got it. Just be careful, okay?
Oh, it's 4:20!
Paul was already gone.
I don't have any weed.
But he left behind one thing.
Oh, you mean the time.
Wait, hold on. Look back at it. Was that addressed to you? Oh, yeah.
I've left this message here for you to find. So that soon. When the time comes and I ask you to choose, you can do so with your eyes open and some hint of understanding. I have no secrets, and the only things I choose to omit are the ones that you, in your current limited state, would not be able to grasp, no matter how hard I try to make you understand. Okay, this is too much. I'm convinced.
He must die.
Yeah. Let me at him. Let me at this final boss.
Four 20's a good minute.
My office? office alarm went off. Is that you skulking around, Jack?
Fuck you. I'm done playing games. I'm here for what you stole.
Yes, of course.
The CFR. If you understood just how much depended on that, you'd leave it alone. But I know you don't care.
You're right. I don't. And it looks like you're not here to stop me.
Yes.
Hey, James.
Yes, everything will play out as it has to play out. I'll see you very soon, Jack.
Just, you guys can look at the chat. Let me know if I can make the box bigger.
He was in Bohemian Rhapsody, the guy there.
What?
Him.
Wait, Aidan Gillen? Or
that guy.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm just gonna make your box bigger.
Fine. Well, you need a bigger box. Wait, they're at the swimming pool.
Alright, so, Pat, you just want to skid over a little bit.
You just went the opposite way that people need to see you.
I don't care if they see me. I'm just stretching my hips out.
Okay, well.
Alright. That was just a couple of minutes between stutters.
The countermeasure was Paul's prize. Everything he built was based on Will's device. His plan depended on it. You better believe I look forward to taking it from him.
So we're trying to get the countermeasure from Paul.
Broke him.
In the year... We're in 2016.
Believe that it could be changed.
Yes.
We're in 2016. Yeah.
And he cast aside the only people who could have...
So we're back to where we were originally? And this is like 2 days after time broke.
Right. We kind of go... in circles.
Yes. Here's the dude.
Just one of you. Rip. Look, you have to realize you're not gonna keep me from the CFR. You don't look like you're in shape for this.
Oh, all my time powers are disabled.
What? That's chill. Wait, so who is Emily Burke again? This isn't even my final form!
Turn to stone!
Medusa that motherfucker.
Duh!
Shoot him in the face!
Face put it into perspective. They were all misled. Manipulated to believing they were doing what was right. What was necessary.
Liam Burke made his choice.
Liam Burke wasn't a...
Fiona, I'm at the CFR chamber. Door's locked.
Liam Burke was a middleman.
I apologize.
We don't have time to think about that.
Since my friend disabled security earlier, I should be able to do this. I don't really know what the plan is, but it's all up to you now.
It's all up to you.
It's like the final frontier.
It was like walking
the
ocean.
Yeah, we're definitely getting towards the final confrontation.
There'd been some kind of struggle chamber. I didn't know the details. Somebody cleaned it up.
A man named Charlie Wincott. I believe he chose to take a stand. Unfortunately, it ended badly for him.
Apparently.
Mm-hmm. Well, it seems to be that kind of work environment.
You know, hostile work environments are a problem in the United States.
Yeah, I'm not okay with it.
So,
I prefer hostile work environments. I feel like the best is brought out of everybody when they're working under their gun, or quite literally with a gun pointed at them.
You know, the gun point thing is meant to be a euphemism, but on the movie,
died for it.
And I knew it could Agia, or Wrath of God, It's often believed that Werner Herzog directed Klaus Kinski in the middle of the Amazon jungle with an AK-47 pointed at his head.
Was dead.
The movie is amazing.
The Monarch had a way of getting to him before that.
Azir Wrath of God, it's one of Werner Herzog's first films. He stole his 35mm camera from his film school and went and shot a movie in the jungle with like seven people and Klaus Kinski. And the movie is freaking just madness embodied. It's like one of the most incredible. It's definitely probably his best film, and it's just like such a thing. And they say that Klaus Kinski and Werner Herzog were in each other's faces so much that they that eventually Werner Herzog would just sit there with the AK-47.
Sounds like a director.
Yes, Azir Wrath of God. You just put it in the trailer. It's a very good film. It's old. It's not for everyone, but it's very good. It's kind of based on the Heart of Darkness. They just kind of go deeper into the dark, the jungle, and it gets weirder and weirder. And it has probably one of my favorite endings in a film of all time. University.
Hooked it up to his own
machine. Machine YouTube.
It was part of his sick desire for control.
Monkeys.
But that gave me one last shot at fixing things.
I could go back.
Maybe get to Will before
Paul
killed him.
Maybe get to Will before Paul killed him.
And if I could get the countermeasure in Will's hands, maybe I could still turn everything around.
I don't know what all these faces are.
Jack,
I don't know what you're doing!
Jack doesn't understand that you can't change time. He still thinks he can.
Core was set, the machine was prepped. I had to put the corridor in place.
I feel like half this game is just turning on time machines.
You
just go from one shootout to another to turn it on a time machine.
It's original title. Time Machine. Let's turn them on.
I'm gonna use some time stuff.
Oh, face shot! But you should also use some time shots now. Don't shoot that when you're next to it. I think they're dead. I think he's dead.
Which ones are real enemies?
The ones that are moving and shooting at you are real.
Look! Man!
I think he's not moving.
We're supposed to step behind him.
Don't! Those are still people who are not moving. Anyone in a jetpack is moving in trying to
one death. That did not go as well. Guys, you're just all faces in the chat. I don't even know what's going on anymore.
Shoot him.
Yeah, pretty good with that charge.
Oh, I did.
Gotta move.
I got him.
Alright, we got this. They're coming. I don't understand all these guys who are in, like, regular equipment and, like, and then all of these, like, super soldiers. It's just like, why don't you super soldiers go take care of it? I'm gonna stand back here with my very generic body armor. You are covered. You need to run.
Okay, here we go.
Fine.
There you go. Get that barrel. There you go.
Jesus. You serious?
It's fine, let it go. Why do people think I'm not okay?
Because they see the crowd you hang out with.
Very slow machine lady. The machine was ready.
Anybody else, Gladys?
The earliest I could go back to was the time the core was first activated. At the university.
Not much time to rescue your brother.
Last night.
I didn't have a choice.
You better be as advertised.
Trying to get some ammo. Not gonna get any ammo. That's cool.
Alright. Oh, Jesus Christ. Hi.
Sorry, I didn't know you were streaming. Am I allowed to
come in? Yeah, come in.
Okay. Well, we have a princess joining us.
Come take my seat. For a second.
I was just trying to get in the open door.
It's fine. Hello.
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 What are you playing? I don't know if this is going to fit on my head.
Quantum Break.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
What's up? I feel like I haven't seen you in a long time.
Yeah. Nice to see you.
Cool. Hi, JJ.
Do you want to?
Kingo is going crazy like someone's here. This is gonna
happen. Some escape the lab.
Oh, just kidding, it does. That's hilarious. Yeah.
This is Jess, guys.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, it's okay.
This is Gladys.
Yes.
I know, right?
So the same voice for Gladys in Portal is the voice for the computer program for this game. Specifically for all the time machines. Because she is the go-to. Right, she's on F4. Hi! Okay, come here. We have a dog!
Just make sure when you put him down, Jeff comes back.
Oh, Jesus. Team is down. Over. Okay, here we go. Pico's on it.
Yeah, I got him.
No, Pico can play.
Oh, okay. Open fire.
Go, Pico. But avoid damage. No one can see the dog in the frame. I'll take him, Jess.
Get behind him!
Oh. So, Jess, why are you dressed like that?
I just got back from work. Which I do on weekends for kids' parties.
Yeah, he dresses Disney villains.
Yeah.
And occasionally Disney villains.
Yeah, he's dead.
Only once, but it was fun.
I got there after the fracture initiated. Too late to stop it all before it ever started.
But not too late to save Will. All you had to do was get to him in time.
Yeah. That was the plan.
I know.
We've got security footage of the Joyce brothers escaping to the server.
All right, I'm gonna take Pico and I'm gonna go get out of this dress. I'm very uncomfortable.
Ready another extraction unit to remove the core.
Good luck, guys.
Thank you.
Have fun.
We shall, I think. Oh!
Sorry!
Cinderella has to go because it's too dirty for her hair.
What? I missed it?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
I'm not hearing any response from Raider Team 3.
Elle McClain, yeah.
We may have a situation.
Wait, yeah. B's left?
Don't drop the dog.
Should have sent me and Burke in first to deal with those.
Everyone says bye. Bye. Yeah, Jess dresses like Disney characters for children's parties.
You're getting hosed, dude.
James, you're a lot of prank.
Whoa! Straight to his face.
I remember that Will and I were heading to the courtyard when the stutter hit.
That might be a thing in Germany. I don't know. I mean, it's like there are party companies in Los Angeles that, like, I know there's. I've got friends who work for like the mermaid companies too, where they just like dress as mermaids and they wear these contraptions at the entrance of the court. So, and so her particular company is like fantasy characters and stuff, and so she dresses as different princesses and goes to children's birthday parties, and she knows how to sing all the songs. And she, like, entertains kids.
Oh, wait.
Courtyard. How do I get there?
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, this is where the fracture first started, where we saw all the students getting taken. And that's the same helicopter.
Seems trippy.
It's very trippy.
We need more drugs.
We're on drugs! Okay, we have to figure out how to get to the courtyard. Why is... Stop. There we go. Oh, there it is.
Oh, this guy got rain in the face.
Yeah, he dies for that.
You destroyed 15 enemy Cronin harnesses. There's a time thing.
There's a time thing?
Right there. Why?
Time thing. Go! God damn it. Do I have to get on it? Maybe I have to get on it.
Possible, maybe jump on it. Although there's specifically the clearance sign, I wonder if it just knocks you off if you try it. Okay, now speed jump and get on top of the thing.
Well, maybe it's not that complicated. So what does this move do? K. kills Chronon harnesses?
Now.
Yeah. Oh! I shouldn't have done that second one.
Okay, I think you got it. Yeah,
but
you
got it. You have to get freeze a truck. Puzzles, man.
Yeah. Wish they would just get rid of those things, the thinking parts of the game.
What? Okay, well. How do I? Is there a sprint?
I think you're doing it all right. You just need to get it right.
I'm just being dumb. Because I can't like dive again. Or can I? Dude!
Yeah! There are a lot of enemies in here.
That's kind of their thing, you know? They appear places.
Henchmen.
Just everywhere. Good luck with the Raag cosplay, guys. They don't make me on any assembly line.
Been hosed.
Indeed. You are filled with lead, sir.
Okay, that did not go well.
He's dead.
Okay, he's dead. Ooh.
When Will and I had escaped from the lab after the experiment, it seemed like Monarch was dealing with somebody other than us. That was me, all along.
HQ, Striker team is down. It's Joyce.
Raider 9, what do you mean Striker team is down? How many?
Student lounge.
That shouldn't be possible. I'm getting reports of gunfire in the underground parking. Are you sure it's Joyce? I need visual confirmation.
Didn't expect two of me, did you?
That's cool. So we're basically overlapping with the old timeline.
Yeah.
That's cool. I like that. Sir,
the hell are you doing down here?
I need the gate passcode. They need me up there.
Fuck if I know. Let's go see Wade.
Gate control. I don't have the code.
Burr, the hell are you doing down here?
I need the gate passcode. They need me there.
Fuck if I know. Let's go see Wade.
At the ground upstairs? They're there.
How come you get all the fun?
Probably because I'm not rocking. Hatch's orders.
fading. I'm gonna go chill in the head.
Cool. I'll find you afterwards.
All right. 665. Hey,
your team prepped for combat, man. I don't have a good feeling about all this.
Everyone say goodbye, James.
Goodbye, James.
Bye, y'all.
Hear more voices. Do you want to shoot some people, Raag?
Yeah.
I just went through pretty intense.
Here, I'm gonna make your box smaller real quick too.
Oh yay! My box is too big. It's too inviting. Too many people in my box.
I've lost you, but it's okay.
I'm talking about things.
Okay, no, it's okay. We're gonna kill things. Where am I going? Forward? Here?
Yes. Oh yeah, I'm sorry we didn't kiss, but that just wasn't on the cards today.
Yeah, I think we're done with the kisses.
I think we're done with kisses today. Last time we counted,
there he is. Oh, all my time powers are gone.
What? Destroy the thing in the middle. Nice.
Plugged in somewhere else. No time to lose. I gotta get to Will.
Or, just there. No time to lose. I just did it.
Yeah, this isn't good.
Oh, this is so cool. We're overlapping in our other version of us. So this is us from the beginning of the game as things are just starting to happen.
Whoa.
And now it's changing the timeline because I'm here and there he's there. What's gonna happen?
Whoa.
Door's still barred. Whoever's here ain't left yet.
How the fuck did Joyce take it?
About these powers is that gives you multiple different ways
to
deal with people.
Yeah.
You can go straight on, you can go a little more sneakily, you can do flanking, you can just bust them in the face straight forward. Let's do the time warp. Aww.
I have to reach Will before it's too late.
Alright, where do I go?
I will kiss Pika, actually. Before the end of this.
No time to lose. I gotta get to Will.
Got to get to Will. Will Wheaton! He's got to get to Will Wheaton. Will.
Shit. Too late. I gotta meet him to the library.
Get on top of the porta potties. Always follow the yellow. The yellow.
Climbing porta potties again.
I feel bad for Beth. Was Jack in love with Beth?
I think they were starting to develop something. I mean, they only kind of knew each other in the heat of the moment while shooting many people, but still.
Yeah, you know, not everything has to have a love story. Especially if the other person gets shot in the face. Oh, there's us.
Beth.
HQ, we've got William Joyce in the library. Waiting orders. Over.
I've got to save myself.
myself. He falls to his death.
One of us.
It's okay. I can't do puzzles. You can't do running. I can't do running either.
Gotta move, Jack.
Roger. Keep a skeleton crew and wait for arrival of Monarch Actual. Everybody else needs to reunite at the Dry Docks Cronin Extraction.
I do want to do the karaoke screen. I'll figure that one out. I did a Jackbox party game on. 5 minutes. We'll do another party.
We're not getting any response from the sniper unit investigating the rooftops as we speak. Keep me posted. The whole sniper unit's wiped. No way he did that on his own. We need to find out who's unaccounted for. This might be an inside job.
What was
Let's
that?
Start a list of who's missing.
I think I heard something. Search the area.
Oh geez, there are people. No, not that one. Hit the other one on the left. Because then you actually get... Yeah, that one.
Jesus!
Enemies. You blew them up real good.
Stand down.
What? Can't jump on the barbed wire.
I'm almost there.
Thank you guys, everyone, for being here, for supporting me, for hanging out in the chat. You guys are all fantastic. Even though you, you're very eager.
You're trying to get him to participate in the human trafficking, and I, for one...
I'm not okay with that, yeah.
Joyce in the library that who they'd spot up.
Hostile, Buck! It's him!
Woo! Joyce is in the library, then how is he also here? Time warping. Again.
No, I'm gonna get the SMG because there's actually ammo for it.
Nice. Isn't there a sniper in this game at some point?
At some point. I'm not gonna be able to get him with that gun.
You're not. No, you gotta go close. You gotta run it. You gotta get that first guy. Nice. Oh, hide! You know, if you stay inside the shield, you can heal up there. If you press B, then just stay there.
I just need a better gun.
Also true. Nice. There you go.
Only took a couple hits.
I mean, you missed the
other
ones.
Oh no.
Hello, a very random cat. Hello, thank you, everyone.
Why are there drag queens?
Gotta get down.
I didn't do it. Not this time.
I mean, the better question is why aren't there drag queens everywhere? So I have cousins who live in Alabama, and one of my cousins married, like... Or no, they live in Georgia.
Fuck.
They live in Atlanta, outside of Atlanta. And one of my cousins married, like, the most southern farm boy. He's a great guy, but he's just, like, very southern, kind of
Becky.
And we took to his first drag show. And it was...
He handled it?
Magnifique. He handled it. He was there. But it definitely was out of his, comfort zone. Yeah, that's the way I put it.
That's what we're here for, Twitch.tv/Raagbot, putting people out of their comfort zones.
That's why I can't risk you opposing me, Will. It doesn't have to end like this. We can't just let this happen.
Go down. Oh, down.
I'm just gonna turn out to be the reason that it exploded to begin with. We're back to the beginning! This is pretty cool.
Jack,
you saved me.
Welcome back.
Hey, I wish.
Here's a present.
Countermeasure. How? Oh, Jack.
Will, come on. Come on, let's go. Monarch had it the whole time. Does it work?
Came back from the future. For me. Fracture wasn't fixed.
Not yet. Does it work?
Theory, yes. We gotta get back to my time machine. Gotta get us back to the time where you came from.
No. Future. No.
It's the only way.
We need to stop the fracture here, in this time. Now.
Oh, Jack, listen to me. Fracture wasn't fixed in the time where you came from. So fixing it here, it's always gonna fail.
People are going to die, Will. You haven't seen what happens between now and then.
No, but you have. What you have done. Has set in motion a chain of events that cannot be broken.
Look, we don't know.
And if it could be broken, it could jeopardize the entire world. We get one shot at this. It's too much at stake, Jack.
Look, I know the stakes, okay?
Cookies sound great. I want to get to cookies.
And you gotta let go, well, Jack.
Cookies?
Yeah, no. We're looking for cookies always.
Everything you have done to get to this place is necessary. Trust me. The past is set, but the future is.
So now kill a lot of people, because you've been in some tight spots.
Hey, I know you've had some shitty past, but murder some
people
now. If
what you said is true, then how did I save you? I saw you die.
Well, think, Jack. You never physically saw me die, did you?
I watched a roof collapse on top of me.
Creating the illusion of my death, yes, which brought you here to make sure it remained only an illusion. It's all a loop. If time is an egg,
no egg metaphors.
Wait, what is it? Let's go look at
it.
It was a mural.
Get down. Over here.
Goddamn bloodbath in there. I need some air.
Cleaners better get here quick.
Wait for them to leave. Now, I know it's a lot to take in, but the fact that you managed to save me and yet still maintain the illusion of my death is actually further proof of my point. The past remains intact.
Stick to the point.
Nothing changes, and the Novikov self-consistency principle prevails.
Oh, great. We can high-five about that later.
Right. Let's save the world first.
Come on. Let's meet up with the convoy.
We don't have time for this.
Jack, no.
You chose to murder people.
Safe. Let's go.
Still stubborn as ever.
Runs in the family.
That was me. I did that. I'm sorry.
In summary, time loop. I'm alive. Science.
Yeah, I got that.
I like how he was just complaining about how people are about to die and then just goes on to murder people. He's like, no, we can't. People are gonna die. Hey, as long as there's not people you care about. You know, faceless henchmen.
And you can't risk helping them.
I know what happens if I don't.
And it'll still happen, Jack. I meant what I said back there. And there are no exceptions. If you get suckered into trying to change what can't be changed, it may cost us everything. Please, Jack. Our future depends on this. You said Monarch had the countermeasure this whole time. How? Why?
Paul was using it to fuel some kind of messed up survival program.
Huh. They must have somehow repurposed it as a localized Kronon field regulator.
Sure.
Of course. Yeah, of course. Well, duh.
Why didn't I think of that?
Right?
I always assumed Mary had to tell us this? The countermeasure,
keeping it safe. She was the one who warned me.
For those of you who aren't in the loop.
I know.
You met her. Is she helping us?
She was.
Ah, I see. Oh, shit, watch out.
Isn't this where you...
Well, hey. Go this way, now.
Paul?
Paul?
Okay, cool. We've got about 20 minutes left in the game, so let's get it done.
Okay. Well, who said that?
Oh, my mod.
Oh.
Go to bed if you're tired. I'm sorry, guys. I played a game. I solved a story. No, I do not name my friend John here. He acts so good. We team up well, like we should. The final moments. Act 5, part 3.
You know, interesting.
You know what? I don't think we've ever upgraded our powers in a long time.
Oh, I don't think we have either. Are we able to? Wait, hold on. The first thing we should do
is upgrade our powers.
See if we can. But I also think this seems to follow a Shakespearean act structure. Because usually Act 5 would have 3 parts, and Acts 1 through 4 would always have like 4 or 5 parts.
Mm.
So that's interesting.
That's interesting. Yeah, I wonder if that... I mean, it seems like it would be intentional. Oh, did I ever tell you that... You remember when we found that screenplay when you were playing?
Yeah.
There are more parts to the screenplay.
Oh! Okay, now I need someone right now on the stream to go find all the parts of the screenplay and post it for us. And then I promise you, on the stream, I'm just going to force Raag to do this, we will do a dramatic reading of the screenplay if someone can find all the parts... I'm assuming there are probably like 2 or 3. I'm assuming there are 3, because that's, you know, rule of threes.
Thank you, Blue Owls and Amy8, for helping me out and modding with me. And thank you for those who are staying up. We're going to go into the final parts of this game, not going for too much longer, but if your body needs sleep, you get sleep.
You know, I like how they have different pieces of soot on their faces. It's like a... It's like a face tat. It's like a Mike Tyson face tat. That's. I think we all need to get in fights and get Mike Tyson face tats. I think that's what should be the new
look,
new fashion.
I know I've kept you in the dark. When I started my work, you were so young, and afterwards, I always hoped it would all pass you by without touching you.
Yeah. I get it.
Come on. But you didn't know it was a master killing machine.
Fix this mess.
Otherwise, you would have gotten me involved earlier. I bet.
Yeah. Superpowered killing machine.
You hid the machine here. You really never used it yourself?
No, I didn't dare. Not after the man came out. It was Paul. He tried to kill me.
Not after the man. The man in the machine. Family.
Damn. Rusted shut. Jack. A hand?
It's the family mop. The family, way. Shoulder.
One more time.
Yeah, right?
How you open a door is with a shoulder bump. Isn't
that... When Monarch came for the time machine at the university, Paul was trapped in it. He escaped into the future. Whatever happened to him there changed it.
Somehow he found my machine there and used it to come back to 1999.
And founded Monarch. He escaped from Monarch and became what he escaped from.
Insanity. I never should have built the machine. I should have left well enough alone.
Hey, what y'all think about that? Because scientists...
What's up?
Scientists, they think so much about if they can. They never think if they should.
Just the way I left it.
There's a huge rat outside my room. It's great.
What?
It just keeps running around.
All right. We'll go to the future.
Kitchy.
A little after your time of departure.
Before the fracture stops permanently. Sweet, is this you're doing? Look at Bryan.
I'm concerned about this.
It'll be dangerous.
Of course it'll be dangerous. At this point, what isn't? I'm gonna have to be curious to try this.
Are people offering to say lullabies to each other? I'd be down for a lullaby. What's your favorite lullaby?
Whichever one doesn't have a copyright on it.
Wow. So this is what it looks like.
Hello, the Manta writes.
When we exit, it'll be a little past the point you were at when you left to save me. That's our window, when we know it can work, before time actually ends for good.
It may not be much of a window. Monarch was sure it was imminent.
Like they're experts.
They kind of are.
All they know, they stole from me. You worry about your end. I'll worry about mine.
He's sounding a little villainous here, don't you think?
That works.
He is.
This is amazing. All those years, I never met.
Crap. Hang on.
So does it turn out at the end that Monarchs are actually the good guys? What a twist that would be.
Got the time knife screenplay from the game.
About to stop for good.
Yes, it is. Hence the lifeboat program.
So this is part one.
People sitting around in a bunker somewhere.
This is part two.
Someone sent it already?
Yeah, in my mod chat. So
okay.
My mod chat.
And the plan depends on it. So
we'll review that. Thank you, sweet.
I'll take that back now, please.
I can't do that.
So is this the fight?
It seems like the fight. Really slow from the center.
This feels like something you should be doing.
I mean, I'm gonna let you just...
You're gonna let me die, basically, what you mean.
That's what's gonna happen, but I believe in your abilities. Defeat Serene.
Make him invulnerable.
Yeah, no. What? Shoot him now. He's on the left,
Now.
There. Oh wait, no, he's up top.
Yes, that's it.
Bomb. Wolf. Alright. Game on.
Alright. We don't have good weapons either.
We don't? Great. Perfect.
Hello, all. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for everyone who's participating. We're going to try and finish this game. We're going to kill these last enemies. We're going to do this. We're going to go through. We're going to be powered up. And we're going to chew this. Charged up!
What do we have?
Woo!
I'm going with this one for sure.
Better not, Jack.
Wait, skip this.
I don't know how Will managed...
Did you just, like, find a secret content?
Did I just skip...
I'm doing great!
The end of the game? There we go.
I'm good, guys. No worries, I'm good.
Jesus, his moves, his powers move. Oh, this is shitty. Oh, this is bad. Okay, here we go. Alright, we're gonna fight from one end to the
reload, end. Reload your gun. This is orange flavored sparkling water. I've been drinking Diet Pepsi and I kind of made the transition to sparkling water and it's kind of gotten me off soda.
Alright, well. Come on. How do you ever make this?
So I'm assuming that sparkling water is big in Europe. That's what you're telling me.
Move.
Press Y to see what enemies are at. Defeat Serene. Now it's Paul.
Can't go any further than this. Oh, jeez. Got him.
Finish him!
Got him! Whew.
By the way, I would just like to state for the record that I liked Littlefinger a lot in Game of Thrones, and I would wanted him to win the whole thing.
Time punch! I wish some of these were actually playable events, because some of the coolest things that happen are done in cutscenes. Like, saving Will from the falling library, that would have been a dope thing to do as a player.
Oh!
Ooh!
You just broke those bones. Woo!
Oh, he did.
And you've got a face smudge.
You know what?
Yeah.
This is a tight spot.
We got out of a tight spot there, guys. Tight spot.
Lullaby, kill a guy. It's a murder party. Lullaby, and tonight you murder all the army guys.
Never mind. Tell me later. We got work to do.
Capone.
Right. I'll have to hook up the countermeasure to the core. It's designed to hypersaturate the Maya Joyce field with chronon particles.
I have a feeling we're gonna have to
time machines like
kill
an amplifier.
Well,
that'll cause a chain reaction and rejuvenate the field. It'll be a universal event.
I'll take your word for it. Just make it happen. What do you need?
The countermeasure's charge is low. We'll need a jolt of chronon particles. A jump start. That's you.
Put my face in it! What'd you do?
The countermeasure. It stitched time back together everywhere. The destruction couldn't be undone. The lives we lost were real. But we fixed it.
Jack.
Will.
Clocks kept on ticking.
Come on. Come on.
I think we just saved the universe.
Aww.
Where's Paul? He's dead. He's gone. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Will, he was wrong about everything.
Was he?
Will. The countermeasure worked.
Did it?
The countermeasure burned out. Should be stable now. Of course, I'll have to run a few tests to confirm. There's no reason to believe that the fracture isn't over.
What's happening to me?
One more question. Paul Serene's entire philosophy was that time is a set path, and nothing can be changed. At the time, you obviously disagreed. But after everything you've seen and done, we need to know. What do you believe now? Was he right? Or is it possible to change things?
I'll come back for you.
All right, that was a pretty cool ending. I bought it.
Also, I don't know if we talked about this last time, but the soundtrack to this thing is awesome. Turn it up.
Miller Rose Bar!
Dominic Monaghan!
the best part of this is if someone were to walk in right now, because we're listening to this on headphones.
Yeah.
Thank you for everyone for joining us, for hanging out.
Alright, where is she? Amelia Rose Blair, Amy Ferraro. Alright. I'm a fan. I'm a big fan of that game.
It was fun. The visuals are amazing. I really like the storytelling aspects. We skipped a lot of the TV shows, but I like the overall thing. I would say that it's like very like broad, super like hit you in the face sci-fi.
Yeah.
Right? Which is like, I would have preferred like a little more like pontification and, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's just such an action sci-fi thing. Yeah. Which, don't get me wrong, like that has its place and stuff.
It was one of those things where sometimes when you get action sci-fi and sci-fi story, they just kind of put buzzwords in front of other words, and they used the word time a lot for a lot of things, or like Cronon. So Cronon modification, Cronon machine, time thing, time bomb. And I think that had they gotten a bit more into it, it would have been the actual like physics and philosophy behind time travel, instead of just some like good guy, bad guy. Because it did. I mean, Will at the end started to see me.
Right.
But was he? Like, there wasn't really a gray.
Well, I also wonder how many different types of endings or things there are. I think the ending is really the ending, but like there are different paths, so I'm interested to see.
Because, you know, no matter how you do it, in the end.
Wait. We're gonna rock up! Oh no, the music just turned.
The music. Are we rocking?
No.
Why do you wanna.
I just wanted to like jump into it until we
the
can like.
The song just ended.
Yeah.
It's a bit too shootery. Okay, some people say it was too shootery. That's.
To be fair, like, yeah, it was really spattery. And I'll be honest, the decision to skip the cinematics I read was like doable. And I don't really feel like it was doable. Like, there were large parts of the story that I was confused about as we kept going. It was just so much. But I mean, at the end of the day, it was a really high budget 12-hour kind of kick in the face.
Yeah.
10-hour, whatever it was.
However long it was. I enjoyed it. I thought it was well acted, well. And even though there were parts of the story that
Africa
we were missing.
Happened after Act 2. And Amelia and the other main characters were in a car, and then it just came onto the car, and they were all there. There's a clip to it. Someone find the clip. There's a clip of Africa playing as we were doing this stream. You can put it in the chat.
There's nothing that 100 men or more can ever do. I bless the rains down in Africa. If you don't like that song, especially if you don't like, I mean, the Toto one is good, but if you don't like the new one by Weezer, I don't understand you. Do you like it?
They're fun.
Okay, good.
Weezer's kind of a band that I feel like, you know, has been, you know, is a little past their heyday, right?
Yeah, they actually have an interesting path, because they're like Madonna as a band.
They've been around a long time.
Where they are around for a long time and they keep just kind of popping up. Except I think Madonna has a bit more of the star quality that they do.
I mean, early 90s, Weezer with Buddy Holly and those albums were fantastic.
Beverly Hills and that's the mid-thousands. But yeah, yes. Buddy Holly has, that is top.
Yeah, Sweater Song. I used to have a band and we played the Sweater Song. I know we did covers in that.
Did you even do like the talking in between the verses?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. And then Say It Aids, that was a good song to do by them too. It's very simple.
It is.
I used to rock that shit on the drums. So.
Cool.
Yeah. This was a fun game to play with you guys. We should switch to the full screen because I feel like we're just playing music for a reason.
Yeah. The question we had about getting more into the science of time travel, that's when it gets difficult, because if you get into the actual science of time travel, then it becomes very complicated.
Well, I think they did have scientists kind of consult on it, and I do think that they kind of set it up so like you could read all this extra story elements, and there are all these things, and we just like skip right
through. Yeah, we were just like, no,
we're not gonna keep going.
No.
Like, so, I mean, it really was built to be this like super high budget, kick in the face blockbuster with like the ability to add more depth, but obviously, I feel like side missions, maybe some like actual beat off the beaten path kind of stuff would have been fun.
Something more open worldy might have helped it out. I do think. Yeah, I think the main story was very streamlined, and I think if you had something like, hey, Beth needs help with this blank, Lifeboat Productions. It's funny because the lifeboat. All right, is there an after scene? That's what I want to know. Quantum Break live action. Oh, it's the live action show. Okay, never mind. Nope. And then the live action show, of course. I never actually watched the episodes. Did you?
I watched a couple.
Okay, and I feel like that probably gave a lot more.
Well, the live action shows were specifically the villains.
Yes.
So the idea is it would only tell the story from, you know, which they had an actor in, like they had a main character actor. I think that was the one that we like froze on the ground. That was the lead of the other show.
Gotcha.
Remember the time where we like shot the guy in the ground and he was just like, some people made stupid choices? That's because he was a good guy on that side. And he was kind of like fizzled out. That was the good guy on that side.
Right.
And he like goes through his whole mission, you meet his family and he does stuff and he tries to be the good guy on the inside trying to figure things out. But
gotcha. So Charlie is the good guy and then Liam was the other.
Correct.
Gotcha.
And so Liam was the lead in the show and so you were following that character kind of go through a whole bunch of stuff.
Okay. Cool. So that's very cool, and that's something that we would have, again, filled out the world a bit more. So I think as far as the scope of the game, and as far as like what they're trying to accomplish, very impressive. I think how we dealt with it, not as impressive. But we played it, and that's what counts.
Yeah.
That's what counts in the end. And we only kissed once, so...
Yeah, and that's all that will ever happen. Can't give it all to you once, guys. It's called foreplay. Oh my god, I can't believe I said that.
It is called foreplay, because next time it's gonna get more. Oh yeah! Here we go! This is just the first one.
I guess it's really cool. Thank you guys for being here and playing through this game with us. We had a good time.
We did.
Yeah. There was all sorts of hijinks on the stream. and there was, you know... thing. I don't know what I did. I didn't know why I did that. I do what I do, and I do what I don't know what I want to do. Is that a lot?
I'm not sure what you just said, and I don't.
I do what I do. What I did. What I wanted to do. If I didn't want to do what I did, want to do.
But you do what you do when you did. But you didn't want to do what you didn't. But you did.
Yeah. Done.
Great. Do that. For those of you in the United States, remember to vote again on Tuesday.
Yeah, totally.
For those of you not in the United States, bother your friends to vote on Tuesday who live in the U.S. And then, Gorsh. I want to stay and hang out, but I don't have anything to talk about. So. What's I mean, you're working through Red Dead, but what are some other things you're working through?
Red Dead's a big thing, and also going to be working through Tomb Raider, the latest one. Me and Jess have been playing through that one, and then we'll probably be doing some other fun, crazy hijinks sometime.
That's fun.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah.
Trying to think of the most, like, frustratingly repetitive game possible in order to play. Somewhere you can just, like... Oh, well.
So we're going to do a raid, and we're going to raid someone who is a cool person, a friend of the stream, and someone who just made partner. And so I want you guys to all, when we raid, Dream Daddy, JJ and I are going to play Dream Daddy, I think. But, you know.
Dream Daddy with Patrick and Jade. Ooh, I'd be down for it. What is Dream Daddy? Oh,
it's
is Dream
gay,
Daddy the date sim?
It's a gay dad simulator.
We have to. We have to do it. I mean, we have to do it. If you guys, okay, write a good Dream Daddy haiku, and I will play. There's no way I won't play. You ready? Oh, here we go.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, that patience is starting to wear pretty thin.
Of course. Right outside.
Mr. Joyce.
He's in the TV show. He's the head.
Finally.
He's Hatch.
Thought you wanted to talk, not get my life story.
Well, you were at the heart of all of this. And you can understand our need to find out exactly what happened.
I heard it's all being pinned on Paul. It's quite the feat.
Paul Serene always danced to his own tune, you know that. He and his delusions did tremendous damage to Monarch, but we can still salvage this company. We could use a man like you. It's not the same Monarch you know, Mr. Joyce. Your exceptional qualities are obvious, and we both know you have certain needs our expertise could help with. We can help each other.
Oh. One last choice to make.
Woo!
Press A to play.
I think we're done. Alright, cool. this is great. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this playthrough of this game. Thank you for supporting the stream and everything like that. We are going to go raid pretty much immediately. I'm going to be streaming more this week. I'm most likely going to play Red Dead some night, and it's going to be great, but I don't know when yet. But it's just going to be me, most likely. I'm going to do a few of those with Red Dead, just because it's just we have so much in that game to get through. But there'll be, you know, a Saturday stream as usual in complement to that, and we'll do some other things. Okay, so when we raid,
okay,
I want everyone in the chat to congratulate Dara Def on her partnership.
Yeah! Congratulations. Come in, person.
Hello? You're right at the end of our stream.
I know, I was going to let you guys finish.
Oh, no, come, you wanna...
Do you want to put your face in the thing?
No.
People want to see you.
They don't need to see me.
Okay.
Cool. Great. Okay, everyone, get ready to raid.
Yo!
Thank you, everyone. And I appreciate you all. Story analysis is sexy. And
Daddy's
John Patrick.
Rog's hair is even hotter. Please bring Patrick back. You guys,
yeah, we appreciate
you guys
all the
have
haikus.
So many haikus. We now have to
today,
play Dream
today
Daddy.
Today was a pretty weird day. JJ is going to play Dream Daddy with me, but maybe we can have him come up.
I mean, I kind of have to. They're begging
they,
for
they
it.
Were, they kind of like, yeah, they kind of jacked
they were at haikus head. About how they want me to be there, so.
Guys, this is my game. Rod's been promising me this since he started months ago.
Yeah, but, apparently I am a Dream Daddy. According to the chat.
You are
so,
a child. You're
yeah,
like
but also at the same time.
This
and your point?
I don't have one.
Okay. We're gonna raid Dardef. Everyone, pass on the left. Congratulations, our partner. Thank you so much for joining us. We will see you soon. This is the Raagbot Zone thing. Thanks, JJ. Thanks, John, Patrick. Follow him on social media. His media information. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Bye.